हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ के एम झा, लेक्चरर VPMP पॉलिटेक्निक गांधीनगर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट यू रिगार्डिंग प्रैक्टिकल्स फ्रॉम द एडवांस जावा। द नेम ऑफ द यूनिट इज JDBC, दैट इज जावा डेटाबेस कनेक्टिविटी। हियर आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू द डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन अबाउट द प्रैक्टिकल 12 एंड प्रैक्टिकल 13 फ्रॉम द यूनिट 3। नाउ लेट अस सी द ऑब्जेक्टिव। After going through this, students would be able to understand how to connect MySQL database by using JDBC with the Java application. It means how to connect Java program along with the database. The database that I am using here, that is MySQL database, it is considered among the type 4 drivers. Practical number 12 from the JDBC. The name of the aim is here. Here we have to develop a user interface, that is UI, that performs the following SQL operations. The first one is insert, second is delete, and the third one is update. And for this, I am going to continue along with the NetBeans and VAM server. In VAM server, I have used my MySQL. You can use your MySQL from the system also, or you can download the MySQL from other site. It is not important to mandatorily use the VAM server, but I am using your VAM server because it is in my system. You can use MySQL or you can download the MySQL alone also to your system. Now we will see here, as the aim is how to develop a user interface. So for that we need to use some, let me go with the aim again. I have to create a user interface that performs the following operation like insert, delete and update. So first of all, I need to create the table. Before I insert the data, it is just an awareness ki yes, I need to create a table before inserting data. I know ki all of the student, you all are knowing this, directly you cannot insert the data. So first of all I need to create the table. So I have opened here my NetBeans and the version is 8.1. I'm using Windows 7. You also check your configuration before you execute your practicals, okay? So first of all, I have created here a table, and it is inside the package name unit 3a Java, and inside the source package, by using this, on source package you can double click and you will get this default package. Here in default package you just click on new and then Java class, and then after you are going to create number of classes inside this, okay? But as I said ki I have to create a JDBC connectivity, and for that one driver is required, because driver drives the Java application up to the database, and from there you can store the data as well as you can fetch the data, okay? So how it is going to drive to the database of MySQL? For that it requires some driver, and the driver is here, as we are using MySQL database, for that it requires a MySQL connector. So how we are using this? It is not directly available in the NetBeans of 8.1. So I had added here MySQL connector Java 5.1.48. I hope it is visible to you all. In library, you just right click. Here you can add jar or folder. You can see here, from here only I have added this MySQL connector of Java. This is the driver, or this is the connector. As the name is connector, it connects Java application along with the MySQL database. And for MySQL database, I have used here VAM server. Okay. From here, you can connect this. Just open it and you can get the yes connector. Now, how you will get this MySQL connector? You just go to here. I have written already MySQL connector Java. Simply, once you write this MySQL connector of Java, you will get number of applications like this. From here you can download this MySQL connector. Yes, select operating system. Yes, it is platform independent. And then you can download the zip file from here. This one. Here the version that is 8.0.23, but in my system it is 5.1.48. But this is how you can download the MySQL connector from the Google. Okay. Now again I am going to start. So this is how I have downloaded the MySQL connector, and what I have used here, that is 5.1.48. You can use the advanced version also, check, but before you do anything, you just check the compatibility or configuration of your system. And this is, I have added here, I have added this MySQL connector inside the libraries by going to, by just clicking on add jar folder, and from there I pluck or I added this connector. Now here I have created the Java file. Here you can see this, I have already taught you what is the use of this for name, why we are using this get connection, how we are creating the statement along with the database, and how we are executing this in the practical 11. For that I have already uploaded the video to you all, and the same thing that we are using here, only the thing which has been changed here, the for name. Here by using this for name function, you are registering the MySQL driver. Only the thing which is been changed here, here we have added the driver of MySQL. In earlier one, I have added type 1 driver, that was JDBC ODBC bridge. That I have already taught you very clearly in the practical 11, and it was already uploaded in your Google Classroom. Okay, so by going through this, you are able to create the table. And here I have created a table here by using this SQL statement. I created a table 6789. It was already created inside the VAM server. It was created there. So simply run it. So you will get the table is already created. So you can change the name also. This is already exist. You can. This is how you can create the table. This is how, by using this statement, you can create the table. As it was already created, table is created already. It is existed there, and that's why we are getting that. Okay. And once if you have used this, you can drop that table also by using this statement. It is inside the comment. Statement.execute, you can drop the table. Earlier I had used the table student, and that's why it is in the comment section. You just skip it. Okay. You just focus over here. You can use any of the table that you are interested. Okay, aap koi bhi bana sakte hain table. Here I have used student 6789. Okay, and the two column that I have used inside the table is ID as well as name. For that I just want to show you how it is. Just go here, go to phpMyAdmin. It was already there. Username is root. And I skip the password, go to go. Here you can see my name of my table is just want to tell you one thing, name of the database is here, MyDB. So this is a database, and inside that database there is a table, that is student 6789. Okay, so here MyDB is the name of my database, and here you can get this table. Okay, just click here. Here, as I said, there are two columns, ID and name. You can get this. Two records are there. ID for Rita is 3 and ID for Pratik is 2. So I hope it is clear to everyone. Here, from here you can insert the other records also. From here you can check the structure. Structure is for whole table. Okay. And you can insert from here. Okay. And if you are manually interested to do everything, then you can go through this one. Here you will get the SQL commands. Okay. Now I am going to my NetBeans. So I just want to tell you where actually the things has been created inside the VAM server. You might have seen that. Now this is how we have created the table 6789. It is inside the database, that is MyDB. Now you can see here the connection is along with the database MyDB, and 3306, it is the default port of MySQL. That's why it is 3306. Now we have to insert the record. The second thing here, you can see these are all SQL statement. Here we have inserted the record. Here you have inserted the record. Okay, here the table, you can see the database name is MyDB. As you might have seen, inside the database MyDB there are number of tables. For that, the table that I have used here, it is, I think it is student. Yes, it is student. It is not 6789, it is student. The table that I am using here is student. It is also inside the database MyDB. Okay, so I am in this, by using this statement, you can, by using this statement you can insert the record. Okay, and once it is inserted, you can delete also by writing the clause. Here I have written id is equal to 3, so that's when there is a SOP, row is deleted. Once it is inserted, row is inserted. But once it was inserted, you are interested to delete that also. This one, you are interested to delete that also. It was inserted there, but after some time you are interested to delete that, then you can delete that by using this SQL statement. So I am going to run this. You can see here 1 and 2, ID number 3 is not available. Here first of all it was inserted, and then after row is deleted, and whatever was left that we have displayed, whatever was left that we had displayed. So how we are displaying this? We are displaying this by using this one. We are displaying the ID and name. So this is result set. Till the next record you are getting, you just go on execution, and once all the records has been completed, you just close the statement and close the connection. That I have already taught you everything, the every silly thing that is present. It is not silly thing, but every small thing which is present here, I have told, already taught you in the classroom. Okay. So this is how you can insert and delete. Also, you can display the data through this. You can display the data through this one. This one is for displaying the data. Okay. I hope it is clear to everyone. This is practical number 12. And you can update the data by using, by simply setting the data. You can update here. Here, you can update the data. Important thing is here, one thing that I forgot to tell you, you have to import sql.star before doing anything, because you are using the basic SQL operation inside your Java application. Okay, and this facility is provided to you by the JDBC. So here you can use, or you can update the data, but you please remind one thing, whenever we are doing any kind of update, it means it should be already present inside the system. And this is how we have updated the data. Run the file and you will get this data as the name was updated by Jeet. Okay. I hope it is clear to everyone now. This is about practical 12, insert, delete, update. Thank you. And I think for practical 13, I would have to create a next practical video that I will create and upload you soon. Thank you again.